butyl, dimethyl silyl chloride in imidazole is used as a protecting of alcohol. So to protect only primary alcohols. So PCC is the, what is the PCC? Pyridinium chlorochromate. Okay, pyridinium chlorochromate. It is used for oxidation of secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohols are oxidized ketones. Okay, so after that, TBAF, tertiary butyl ammonium fluoride. It is used for deproduction of the alcohols. So deproduction of the alcohols. Okay, right. So next, protecting groups for alcohols. So that is benzyl ether protecting groups. Benzyl ether protecting groups. Okay, so alkyl ethers. Inta mundu manam em chesnamu only mana silyl ethers matrame use chesnamu. Okay na. So ippudu second one endi benzyl ethers. Ante alcohols are converted into benzyl ethers. Benzyl ethers. Okay. So first formation of benzyl ether. Alcohol. So alcohol in presence of sodium hydride. So reacts with benzyl bromide. Okay. Benzyl bromide, that is phenyl group CH2 and Br. So that is called benzyl bromide. Okay. When benzyl bromide reacts with alcohol in presence of sodium hydride. Okay. So it gives benzyl ether. Okay. So benzyl ether protecting group. Okay. Benzyl ether is the protecting group for alcohol. Protecting groups for alcohol. Okay. So we can get back alcohol. Alcohols the hydrolysis, hydrogenolysis of benzyl ether produces alcohol and toluene. Okay. So it is selectively used to cleave benzyl ether protecting groups. Hydrogenolysis is nothing but hydrogenation or reduction. Hydrogen in presence of palladium and carbon. Okay, so that is cleavage. So cleavage of the protecting groups. Okay, so next, so protecting groups for alcohol, that is cyclic ester protecting groups. So first one, silyl ether protecting groups. So second one is the benzyl ether protecting groups. Third one is the cyclic acetal protecting groups. Cyclic ester protecting groups means, okay, 1,2-diols. Whenever 1,2-diols reacts with aldehydes or ketones, so they form acetals. Okay, so see in the above example, 1,2-dihydroxy compound, so reacts with ketone, so it forms cyclic acetal. Okay, cyclic ester also, so protecting group for alcohol. Okay, so what is the cleavage? Okay, so I want to get back 1,2-dihydroxy compounds and carbonyl compounds. So cleavage, so that is acid catalyzed hydrolysis of cyclic esters produces dihydroxy. So that is 1,2-diol and ketone. Okay, so in protecting groups, first of all we have to protect the hydroxy groups and deprotection. So that is formation of protecting groups. So next, cleavage of protecting groups. So that is nothing but protection of alcohol and deprotection of the alcohol. అంటే మళ్ళీ మనము ఏం చేస్తాం, ఫస్ట్ హైడ్రాక్సీ కాంపౌండ్స్ ని ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తాం. సో ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేసిన తర్వాత మళ్ళీ మనకు హైడ్రాక్సీ కాంపౌండ్ కావాలంటే దాన్ని ఏం చేస్తాము, సో డీప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తాము. సో డీప్రొటెక్ట్ చేయడానికి ఓకేనా, సో కండిషన్స్ ఏంటి, సో యాసిడ్ హైడ్రాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ సైక్లిక్ ఎస్టాల్స్. ఓకే, సో ప్రొడ్యూసెస్ 1,2-డయోల్ అండ్ కీటోన్. 1,2-డయోల్ అండ్ కీటోన్. ఓకే, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అ రివర్స్ రియాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ సైక్లిక్ ఎస్టాల్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ గ్రూప్స్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్, సో ఇది అవసరం లేదు, ఇది ఆల్రెడీ మనము డిస్కస్ చేసినాము ఇంతకుముందే, రైట్. same. Okay, so next protecting groups for aldehydes and ketones. ఇంతకుముందు ఏం డిస్కస్ చేసినాము? సో వి డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ గ్రూప్స్ ఫర్ ఆల్కహాల్స్ ఓన్లీ. ఓకే, నౌ ద సెకండ్ వన్ దట్ ఈస్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ గ్రూప్స్ ఫర్ ఆల్డిహైడ్స్ అండ్ కీటోన్స్. ఓకే, ఆల్డిహైడ్స్ అండ్ కీటోన్స్ కెన్ బి కన్వర్టెడ్ ఇంటూ ఎస్టాల్స్ అండ్ కీటాల్స్. ఎస్టాల్స్ అండ్ కీటాల్స్. ఓకే, సో ఎస్టాల్ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ గ్రూప్. సో ఫస్ట్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎస్టాల్స్ ఆర్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ కీటాల్స్. ఓకే, సో ఇఫ్ 1,2-diol reacts with aldehyde or ketone, okay, so you will get to acetal and ketal protecting groups. Okay, so formation of acetals and ketals, so that is 1,3-dioxanes. Okay, so these are the protecting groups of aldehydes and ketones. So cleavage or deprotecting, so always remember one thing. So deprotection of esters or cyclic esters or ketals, okay, so that is acid hydrolysis. Acid catalyzed hydrolysis produces aldehydes, ketones, aldehydes or ketones and 1,2-dihydroxy compounds. So that is cleavage or deprotection. We can call it as a deprotection or cleavage. Okay, so first one is the formation of acetal or ketal. So second step is the cleavage of acetals and ketals protecting groups. So cleavage, so that is acid hydrolysis. That is acid hydrolysis. Okay, see here, this is aldehyde and 1,2-dihydroxy, 1,2-diol. Okay, so it forms, okay, 1,3 dioxane, so that is called ketal. That is called ketal. Okay, so this is formation of ketal protecting groups. Formation of ketal protecting groups. Okay, so after production, so I want to deprotect the ketal or ester. Okay, so for deprotection, so we have to use acid catalyzed hydrolysis or acid hydrolysis. So acid hydrolysis of 1,3 dioxane or acetal or ketal. Okay, so acid hydrolysis of acetal, acid hydrolysis of ketal, so that produces ketone, that produces ketone and 1,2-diol. Okay, so that is reverse reaction. So deprotection is the reverse reaction of protecting groups. So this is about protecting groups for aldehydes and ketones. Okay, so these examples only. Okay, so avasaram ledhu, idi chaala pedda undi, avasaram ledhu. Okay, so intha mundu previous example nunchi chudi, idu okkade saripothundi. Okay, explain the protecting groups for aldehydes and ketones ante. Okay, so you have to write only so these two reactions. First, so formation of ester protecting groups and cleavage reaction. So cleavage reaction is nothing but acid hydrolysis of ester or acid hydrolysis of ketal. Okay, so this much enough. So it also need the example also need. So next, so protecting groups for carboxylic acids. Okay, how to protect carboxylic acids? Okay, so carboxylic acids are being converted into esters. Okay, so by converting into esters only, okay, now so carboxylic acids can be protected. Okay, so carboxylic acids can release H plus ions. Okay, so H plus ions can be abstracted by bases. Okay, so diazomethane, that is CH2N2. So whenever the diazomethane reacts with the carboxylic acid, okay, so it produces ester and nitrogen gas. Okay, the common ester protecting groups for carboxylic acids are methyl ethyl benzyl ester. Methyl ethyl benzyl ester. Okay, so it is a methyl ester, and we can form benzyl ester, and we can prepare ethyl esters also. Okay, here so only we discussed. Okay, we are discussing about only. So we are discussing about only methyl ester. So formation of methyl ester. Okay, so by converting carboxylic acid. So it is a carboxylic acid. When carboxylic acid reacts with diazomethane. Okay, so when carboxylic acid. So this is carboxylic acid. Okay, so carboxylic acids reacts with diazomethane and they form esters. So methyl ester means, so this is the methyl group. Okay, so methyl group, that's why it is called methyl ester. Okay, so this is the way of protecting carboxylic acids. Okay, so by converting carboxylic acids into esters, so we can protect the carboxylic acids functional group. Okay, next, second step, so that is cleavage. Okay, so cleavage or deprotection. So first one is the formation or protecting of carboxylic acids. Okay, so second one is the cleavage of protecting groups. Okay, so the protecting group, that is methyl ester. So methyl esters, so being converted into carboxylic acids by reacting with lithium hydroxide and hydrogen peroxide. Okay, lithium hydroxide and hydrogen peroxide. So these agents are used. Okay, to deprotect. Okay, esters into carboxylic acids. Okay, so this is about protecting groups for carboxylic acids. Okay, so carboxylic groups, they produce H plus ions. Okay, acidic proton can be abstracted by bases. Okay, so whenever carboxylic acids reacts with the diazomethane, so they form methyl ester or ethyl ester. So this is diazomethane, so that's why we'll get to methyl ester. Okay, so methyl ester can be converted into carboxylic acid. Okay, by reacting with lithium hydroxide and H2O2. So it is a oxidizing reagent. Okay, so this is about protecting groups for carboxylic acids. So it is another example. So that is directly we can convert carboxylic acids into esters. So by reacting with alcohol in presence of HCl. Okay, so formation of esters from carboxylic acids. Okay, it is also protecting groups for production of the carboxylic acid. Ethyl or benzyl esters are prepared based on the following reaction. Okay, the previous reaction. So we can prepare only methyl ester. So we cannot prepare benzyl esters. We cannot prepare ethyl ester by using diazomethane. By using diazomethane, we can prepare only methyl esters. Okay, so if you want to protect carboxylic acids. Okay, so by forming ethyl or benzyl esters, so we have to follow the second reaction. So that is carboxylic acids should be react with alcohol in HCl solution. So that is formation of esters. Okay, so mild conditions for esterification. So that is DCC is used. So that is 1,3 dicyclohexyl carbodiamide. So this is called DCC. Okay, in presence of DCC, carboxylic acids reacts with reacts with two alcohols, they form ester. So this is the way of formation of esters. Way of formation of esters. Okay. So the following reaction no need. Ida avasaram ledu. Okay. Ikkada varaku raste saripothadu. Next. So this is the mechanism. మెకానిజం అవసరం లేదమ్మా, ఇది కొంచెం పెద్దగా ఉంటది, పీజీ లెవెల్ వాళ్ళకి మీకు అవసరం లేదు. యూ కెన్ రైట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఆల్సో, కార్బాక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్, ఆల్కహాల్ ఇన్ ప్రెసెన్స్ ఆఫ్ డిసిసి. ఓకే, యూ విల్ గెట్ టు ఇథైల్ ఎస్టర్. ఓకే, సో ఇథైల్ ఎస్టర్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రియాక్ట్స్ విత్ లిథియం హైడ్రాక్సైడ్ ఇన్ H2O2, యూ విల్ గెట్ కార్బాక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్ అండ్ ఆల్కహాల్. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద రివర్స్ రియాక్షన్ ఫర్ ఫస్ట్ రియాక్షన్. సో ఫస్ట్ రియాక్షన్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్, ఓకే, సో ఆల్కహాల్ అండ్ కార్బాక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్. సో ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ రియాక్షన్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్, కార్బాక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్ అండ్ ఆల్కహాల్. ఓకే, సో ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎస్టర్. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఈస్ డీ ప్రొడక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎస్టర్. సో ఎస్టర్ converted into carboxylic acid and alcohol. So first formation of ester, so that is from carboxylic acid and alcohol. Okay, so by using DCC, this is protecting groups for carboxylic acid. So next, so formation of benzyl esters, same formation of benzyl esters are also same. Carboxylic acids reacts with benzyl alcohol. So benzyl alcohol, the structure of the benzyl alcohol is, okay, benzene and CH2 group and OH. So koncham baga chestunnanandi, wait. Benzene ring and CH2 group and OH. Okay, so the name antamu manamu benzyl alcohol antam. So this is called benzyl alcohol. Okay, so carboxylic acids in presence of DCC reacts with the benzyl alcohol and they form benzyl esters. Okay, so we have discussed about methyl ester, we have discussed about ethyl ester. Now I am discussing benzyl esters. So these three are the protecting groups for carboxylic acids. Okay, so in methyl ester, ethyl ester, okay, so we get back carboxylic acids and alcohol. Okay, so by react with lithium hydroxide and hydrogen peroxide. But in case of benzyl esters, okay, so hydrogenolysis is the cleavage of benzyl alcohol. So that is hydrogenolysis. Okay, so not reacting with lithium hydroxide or H2O2. Okay, so very mild method for most functional group. So expect with alkenes, alkynes and nitriles. Okay, that is by hydrogenolysis. So we'll get to carboxylic acid and toluene. Okay, so this is about protecting groups for carboxylic acids. So first one, so protecting groups carboxylic acids is methyl esters, formation of methyl esters. Second one is formation of ethyl esters, and third one is the formation of benzyl esters. Cleavage, so that is by hydrogenolysis. Hydrogenolysis means hydrogen in presence of palladium catalyst, palladium by carbon, so it is a catalyst. Okay, on palladium surface, hydrogen molecules are adsorbed on the surface of palladium. Okay, So on hydrogen analysis, you will get carboxylic acid and toluene. Carboxylic acid and toluene. So it is a not reverse reaction for the formation of benzyl ester. Not a reverse reaction, but in this case only. So we'll get the starting material that is carboxylic acid. That is carboxylic acid. Okay. So this is about protecting groups for the carboxylic acids. Next, protecting groups for amino groups. So till now we have discussed protecting groups for alcohols, protecting groups for aldehydes and ketones, protecting groups for carboxylic acids. So the fourth one, so that is protecting groups for amino groups. So that is carbamate protecting groups. Okay, so that is formation of carbamate. Okay, tertiary butyl oxycarbonyl protecting groups. Tertiary butyl. So tertiary butyl means OH groups. Okay, so attached to tertiary carbon. So this is called tertiary butyl group. So tertiary butyl group. So this is tertiary butyl group and tertiary butyl group. There are two tertiary butyl groups and oxygen also there. Oxygen atom also there. So that's why it is called tertiary butyl. So this is called tertiary butyl oxy. Okay, carbonyl. Okay, carbamate. దీన్ని మనము ఏమంటాము కార్బోమేట్ అంటాం. ఓకే, సో కాబట్టి ఇందులో చూడండి, సో ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ కార్బోమేట్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద కార్బోమేట్. ఓకే, సో అమైన్స్, ప్రైమరీ అమైన్స్ ఆర్ సెకండరీ అమైన్స్. ఓకే, సో వెన్ ఎవర్ దే రియాక్ట్ విత్ డై టెర్షియరీ బ్యూటైల్, ఓకే, డై కార్బోమేట్. So this is called dicarbonate. So one, this is called dicarbonate. Pen wale condition. Okay. So see, ditertiary butyl. So this is tertiary butyl group, and this is a tertiary butyl group. So that's why ditertiary butyl dicarbonate. So dinanta kalpe manamu dicarbonate antam. Okay. So ditertiary butyl dicarbonate reacts with two primary amines. Okay, so they form tertiary butoxy carbonyl. So this is called tertiary butoxy, so carbonyl group. So that is DOC. Okay, so tertiary butyl oxycarbonyl protecting groups. Okay, tertiary butyl oxycarbonyl protecting groups. Okay, so this is the example. So alanine is converted into the following compound. Okay, so this example no need. So this first one is enough. Idokati saripothadi. Okay, so that is production of amino group. So this is the way of formation of carbamate protecting group. Okay, so carbamate protecting group is converted into amine. Okay, in presence of acids. Okay, H plus ions. So directly reacts with the carbamate protecting group, and they form amines. See, so it is a carbamate. So cleavage of carbamate. So in the first one, so this is formation of carbamate. And this one is the cleavage of carbamate in presence of H plus ion. So that is nothing but to acid hydrolysis. Okay, so you will get back amines. So that is R and H2, that is amine. So these also examples for protecting carbamate. See, so cleavage, so one more way of cleavage. So that is hydrogenolysis. Hydrogenolysis of carbamate. Okay. So you will get amine, carbon dioxide, and toluene. Okay. So this is second method for protecting the amino groups and the cleavage of the amino groups, protecting groups for amino groups. That is formation of carbamate and cleavage of the carbamate. So this is cleavage of the carbamate. So that is hydrogenolysis. Next. Right.
ఉపయోగించుకుంటున్నాము దానికి అధ్యయనం చేస్తున్నాము